Hi creators, today I'm going to show you how easy it is to make a video from an image sequence with a transparent background. So let's get started. I've been using DaVinci Resolve since about version 11. And so as each version is released, it becomes more and more like kind of a combination of Adobe After Effects and Adobe Premiere. And so one of the great things I used to use Adobe After Effects for was to take image sequences and turn them into a transparent video. And so today I'm going to just show you quickly how to do that with DaVinci Resolve. And so we're going to open a new project. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to add our images in to the media bin. And so we just need to open up our folder where all those images are stored, and DaVinci Resolve does something pretty amazing. So if you open up that folder where you have the image sequence, they're all kind of already bunched together, which is really cool. You don't have to select them. You can just kind of grab that file, and I can scrub through there, and you can see it's already really a video. So I'm going to pull that down into our media. And I'm going to pull this other file while I'm there. And we're going to go into edit. And as we can see, it's kind of says the range of the images is already there. And you can pull that right in here to your timeline. I'll spread that out a little bit. And so you can see here's our nice animation here that I imported in. So I'm going to go ahead and create another track. Video track. I'm going to move this one up to the top so it's on top. So as you know, DaVinci Resolve kind of runs in a stack here, so everything on top is going to be shown first. And so we would expect anything behind this layer to be shown behind it. And so I just want to show you how this is a transparent video here. So you can see if I put a background in there, our image sequence on top is just nicely sits down behind there. And then it's very easy to export that. You can add your colors in if you want. I'm not going to do that. Edit your audio. I don't have any audio in this file, but if we want to deliver this, and say I want to put this into I'm just going to do an MP4. So the standard is 6,000. Let me go to 6,000 here for this. It gives us a pretty good image. Kilobytes per second. And everything else looks pretty good here. I'm going to name my file image sequence test. And we'll go ahead and add that. It's going to ask me where to put it. And I'm just going to put it into I'll just put it here on the desktop. Okay, so there it is. This is not a really fast machine, it's just a laptop, but I'll show you how fast this can render. All done. So now I have that video on my desktop. Just go there. So here it is. Go ahead and open it. And there's our movie. So pretty simple. So that's a quick way to take an image sequence and make it into a movie. And so to me, that's actually a lot faster than doing it in After Effects. Like I said, when you bring it in, it already kind of combines it together as a video. That actual sequence, you don't have to select it. It just shows it as an actual movie when you bring it in. And I don't have to switch from After Effects to Premiere to do anything. If I was doing other editing in that timeline, I wouldn't have to go back and forth between After Effects. So that's kind of a time saver. So great. So hopefully you guys can use that in one of your projects and give that a try. I find that's very quick and useful for me. And so please subscribe to the channel and post comments, and I'll try to answer questions if I can in the comments. But take care, guys.